All right, team coverage on our top story this morning. KMBC 9's Brenda Washington is in Baxter Springs, Kansas, one of the hardest hit areas from Sunday's tornadoes.
And Brenda, we know that 60 or 70 homes there were destroyed.
That's right, and we are outside the home of Kenneth McCumber, and I cannot believe that he actually spent the night inside of his house, one of the ones destroyed by the tornado that just made a wide path through Baxter Springs. And Kenneth, all this stuff that's in your yard, you were telling me this is from a garage along with batteries from blocks away, and then where did this power pole come from?
Across the street.
From across the street?
Yeah.
Okay.
Some of it's in the backyard.
Now, point out where you, I can't believe you stayed here last night, but you said you wanted to protect your home against looters, but
yeah.
Where were you and your grandchildren, where were you inside this house last night?
There's a closet right on the other side of that bathroom window there, and we stayed in the closet, and about 30 seconds, it was over.
You said you could hardly keep the door closed?
It was everything I could do to hold it.
Now, where were you when the tornado actually hit? Were you watching it from your yard, or
we had a siren go off, and then about 2 minutes later it hit, and
you just barely had time to make it to the closet. Okay, we're gonna walk down here a little bit. What other damage? I mean, your whole neighborhood here is just, I mean, it's literally destroyed. Have you been able to meet up with any of your neighbors?
Yeah, we have two on the other side, and they're camped out in their side yard.
Oh my gosh, look at even more devastation.
And there's the rest of the telephone pole.
The rest of the telephone pole there, more devastation.
Yeah.
But you know what, I'm told that you guys are really a tough, you're tough people here in Baxter Springs, and that you'll pick up the pieces and go on after this.
Yeah.
I guess you have to. Well, listen, thank you very much for talking with us this morning. Good luck to you, and I hope that you and your neighbors can get your homes fixed up pretty quickly here. And guys, so we're going to walk walk here a little bit more before I throw it back to you. I mean, as far as the eye can see, at least from Kenneth's house, you can just see the destruction. We're talking about 60 to 70 homes destroyed here in Baxter Springs, 25 businesses destroyed. So there's a lot that's going to have to be done to rebuild this town, a lot of picking up the pieces for the folks that live here. Now, we're told 25 people injured, one person dead, but they believe it's possible that one person may have had a medical emergency. Early in the morning, when the sun comes up even more, we're told there probably will be some more search and rescue. They have already gone through a lot of these homes once before, but just want to make triply sure that they have not missed anyone. Brenda Washington, KMBC 9 News.